Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray. In this video, I'll show you how to perform inspections with CAD data and a polygonized mesh. We'll look at the part's overall conformity to the CAD, we'll inspect specific geometric features, and I'll show you how to check the distance of volume defects to CAD, which is handy if the part still needs to be machined. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. We'll be working with a project that contains the measured volume, a volume created by the function identify materials, a part with the linked volume, an actual mesh, a volume defect element, and the volume region that was created by identify materials. If you watched the video How to Process Volume Data in ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray, you may remember that this part consists of two materials. We used identify materials to separate them into two parts. For this video, I'll use only the plastic part, which is already polygonized to speed things up. Let's start by importing CAD data. Simply drag and drop the CAD file into your project. Whenever you import data, the software opens the import dialog. Here, you'll have different options depending on the type of data and the elements that are already in your project. In this case, I can create a new part, add the CAD to the existing part, or add the data to the clipboard. We'll talk more about import options a bit later. First, let's talk about import templates. Here on the right, you see a description of the selected import template. Let's take a closer look at it. You can use Edit Template to look at it and change it. When you import CAD data, the software converts the CAD into a triangulated mesh in order to compare it to the measuring data. To do that, you need to specify the triangulation parameters. The most important one is the mesh resolution under triangulation. The import filter is helpful when you're working with extensive CAD files. You can use it to include or exclude certain elements of the CAD. This can speed up the import process. One thing I want to point out here is that ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray also supports the import of PMI data, which can speed up your inspections tremendously. If you want more information, check out the Inspect GDNT Analysis e-learning. This default import template usually leads to good results, but feel free to adjust it if it doesn't work for your applications. For more information about the different templates, look at the tech guide. Now, back to the import options. We'll use Add to Part because I want to add the CAD to the existing part. If you want to find out more about the import option Clipboard, check out this video from the ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D Starter Guide, or take a look at the tech guide. If you look at the data in this project, you'll see that the CAD and actual data don't align. That's because they're aligned in their respective coordinate systems. When you look at the status of your project, you'll see the part of the status bar is red. Click it to open the project guide. The tab Project Guide helps you with your inspections by providing hints and possible actions. As you can see here, you need to create an alignment in order to compare the actual data to the nominal data. All you need to do now is click Create Alignment. You can have more than one alignment in your project, but you usually start with an initial alignment to bring the two datasets together. And that's exactly what the software suggests. So let's create a pre-alignment volume. The software aligns the actual data in your part to the CAD. For more information about the pre-alignment, look at the tech guide. Now let's compare the CAD to the actual mesh. ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray can display the deviations of the actual data to the nominal over all coordinates. To do that, use surface comparison on CAD. You can adjust the legend by clicking the upper or lower limit. Link the two limits to scale the legend symmetrically for positive and negative deviations. Red indicates that the material lies above the CAD surface. Blue means that the material lies below the CAD surface. When I switch back to the multi-view, you can see that you can visualize the results both in 3D and in 2D. You can also display the volume or the mesh in addition to the surface comparison. To obtain discrete values, use deviation labels. Open point inspections in the main toolbar and select deviation labels. Press Ctrl and move the cursor over an area to get a preview. To create the deviation label, press Ctrl and the left mouse button. You can create deviation labels in the 3D view and in the section views. To see the mouse commands associated with a function, have a look at the tooltip down here. To exit the function, click the right mouse button or press Escape. You can also display a go/no-go representation of the surface comparison. To do that, right-click the legend and under Legend Type, select Tolerance Legend. The representation shows if the deviations are inside or outside of a given tolerance. You can edit the tolerance for the surface comparison in the Properties window. Next, I want to show you how to inspect geometric features in ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray. To show you, I'll expand the 3D view and display the CAD exclusively. To inspect elements, you need to construct them first. I want to inspect the diameter of this inner cylinder. When you have CAD data in your project, we recommend constructing all the elements on your CAD. This allows you to exchange the measuring data later. To create the cylinder, open Construct, Cylinder, Auto Cylinder Nominal. To define the cylinder, click a point with Ctrl and the left mouse button. Then click Create and Close. As you can see, the software displays a warning. Open the project guide to find out why. The software indicates that the measuring principle is missing. As I said before, we recommend constructing elements on the CAD. To obtain the corresponding elements on your actual mesh, you need a measuring principle. The measuring principle determines how the element, in this case the cylinder, will be computed on the actual mesh. You can apply the measuring principle directly in the project guide, or you can open iInspect with Ctrl and the right mouse button. Select Measuring Principle and apply a suitable measuring principle. We'll use the measuring principle Fitting Element. Let's quickly talk about color codes in the software. Nominal elements always have a blue icon, actual elements always have a green one, as you can see with the cylinders we just created. Now all that's left to do is apply one or multiple checks. I want to check the cylinder diameter. To do that, select the nominal cylinder. In iInspect, open Check and select Diameter. The software automatically checks against nominal. If you want, you can enter a tolerance manually or use one of the available standards. I'll enter the tolerance manually. And here's your result for the cylinder check. You can also visualize the check in the multi-view. And if you don't have a CAD, you can create elements directly on your mesh, using the function Fitting Cylinder, for example. Consult the tech guide if you want more information about that. The last thing I want to show you in this video is how to check the distance of volume defects to CAD. This can be handy if your part still needs to be machined. To do that, I'll use the volume defect element in my part. For more information about volume defect elements, look at the video How to Analyze Volume Defects in ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray, or consult the tech guide. I'll display the linked volume and the volume defect element in the multi-view. To check the distance to CAD, open Volume Defect Analysis in the main toolbar. Then select Distance Volume Defects to CAD. If you have more than one volume defect element in your project, you can select one here. Enter a tolerance, then click OK to create the check. The result is a color deviation representation. You can visualize the check in 2D and 3D using the multi-view. The legend gives you an indication of the value range, If you want discrete values for certain defects, you can use deviation labels. That's it for this video. If you want to find out more about reporting, check out the next video in this playlist. And if you're looking for a more comprehensive training, check out the INSPECT X-Ray Basic e-learning. You'll find the link in the description below.